Hello guys, welcome to day 3 of 21 days of code with Ozone. I'm here with the first problem for today. The problem is consecutive characters. And the problem statement reads as follows. Given a string s, the power of the string is the maximum length of a non-empty substring that contains only one unique character, and return the power of the string. So, what the problem is trying to ask us? It basically demands us to return the power of a string, where the power is defined in such a manner that the power is equal to maximum length of a substring that's possible with the given string, which contains equal characters. Now, what do they mean here by equal chars? For example, the substring is CCC. So here, the three characters are C, 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 and the three are equal to each other. So we can simply return the length of the substring as 3, and we need to find all such substring and compute the maximum out of them. It might sound a bit trickier at the first, but let us try to dig into the example so that you get a clear understanding of what the problem actually says. So for the example, we'll be taking lead code as a string s and try to perform multiple operations on it so as to return the power of the string. So here I have a variable max, which will be keeping a track of the maximum length substring that we have encountered till now. The instinctive idea behind this problem can be simply use a stack and keep a track of the incoming character. If that character is equal to the existing character at the top of the stack, then we can simply push in that. But if the characters are not equal, we need to update our max such that max is equal to the maximum of the existing max and the size of the stack. Why size of the stack? Because stack will only contain the characters that are equal, because whenever we are encountering an unequal character, we are emptying the stack and again refilling it from that character. So at last we'll have the length of the maximum length substring in our max variable. Let us now perform multiple operations on this given string and understand the flow of characters into the stack and out of the stack. So our first character here is L. Stack is empty, so we can simply push in L. Now we have encountered character E, that's our incoming character. Now if we compare the top of stack, that is L, and E, they are certainly not equal. So as we have discussed, we need to update our max and empty the stack and then start pushing the characters that are coming. So for this case, size of the stack is 1, and initially our max variable was 0. So which is greater, 0 or 1? Obviously 1. So our max now will become 1. Also, we'll be popping out L and pushing in E. Here we have finished two characters from the string. Now moving on to the third character, which is also E. Now we go on to the top of the stack and compare. Is E equal to E? Yes, they are equal. So we'll just simply push E inside the stack. Now for the next char, that is T. We'll compare T with the top of stack. Are T and E equal? No, they are not equal. So what we need to do now is update our max variable with the following formula. Our max is equal to max of max comma stack dot size. We'll be using this formula to update our max variable now. As you can see, the size of stack is 2 and max is 1, and 2 is greater than 1, so our max will be updated to 2. We'll be emptying the stack by popping out all the E's, and then we'll be pushing T into the stack. C is the new incoming character. So here, is C equal to T? No, they're not equal. So again, we need to update our max variable and pop out T. But hey, what we see is that max is already 2 and size of stack is 1. So our max would remain 2 itself, and we'll pop out T and instead push in C there. Now next char is O. O is again not equal to C. So we'll just keep repeating the process until we finish up all the characters of our string. And what we are left is that value of our max is 2. And this is the power of the string. Now let's jump right into the code. So for the code, as discussed, we'll be needing a variable max to store the power. Also, we'll need a stack to keep the count of characters. So let's first initialize our data structures and then we'll begin filling them one by one. Now we'll be iterating the string s character by character and doing the check as we discussed in the algorithm. Why we're using this condition not equal to stk.isEmpty? That's here for a reason, and that's because we need to keep a track whether a stack is containing something or not, because if we try to check the top of the stack in the case when stack is empty, it will return us a null pointer exception, and we don't want that to happen in our case. So every time we are trying to check the top of the stack, we'll also ensure that the stack is not empty. So in the case when the top of the stack is not equal to char ch, that's the incoming character, what we need to do is that update our marks variable and also empty the stack. For this check, we simply push in the incoming character into the stack. And towards the end of this condition, what we do is simply return marks. Now, let's try to run the sample test cases. Okay, the first one passed. Now let's try the second one. So it passes the example test cases. Now let's try to submit the code to this problem. Okay, it worked. Thank you.